Hi, last class we have seen toolpath, pocket toolpath, all the options we have seen. We'll make on finishing in pocket toolpath. We have not seen the finishing. So we have seen only roughing. Now we'll make one rough toolpath and also the finishing toolpath, and we'll study all the parameters. Okay. Then you select the tool and give the feed rate, plunge rate, and the thing. So in here, in this case, I am not giving any stock here. Okay, in the roughing I will select this all parameter we have seen. Now there is a option called finishing. This we have not seen detail, so now we will see in detail about this. You can do roughing and finishing separately also. If you want, you don't want roughing, only finishing you can do it. Or if you want only roughing, you can switch on only roughing, switch off the finishing. Both are possible. So now I'll go modify this parameter absolute. This depth is 0.8 minus 0.8. So I'll make it 2 mm, so that 1 mm for opening. Okay. And the depth of cut I will change it to 0.5. So now you can see it's made very fast. Only finishing I have selected here. I have not done any roughing. You want, you can switch on the roughing also. Okay. And regenerate. So now I added a roughing, then finishing. Okay. So after roughing, it will do the finishing. This job has having some criticality. Before seeing the that one, we'll see the options available in the finishing first. Then we'll go on that. Okay. So one pass. If you want, you can give two passes, and spacing you can give 0.2. I have given. So we have switched on only finish outer boundary. Okay. I think yes, it's look a little confused. So we'll make see in the top view. You can whether we can able to differentiate. So the last, okay. So it's better you can switch off the roughing so that we can understand the finishing, whether two passes is happening or not. I'm regenerating. Now you can able to see two passes. So like this finishing, you can increase the number of passes in the finishing. So the next the finish outer boundary, you can like this, you can finish the outer boundary. Machine finish pass only final depth. Like this also you can do. By doing this, every pass it will not do the finishing. Only on the last pass it will do the finishing. You can see, so it will enter into the full depth and it will cut the finish passes. Machine. So next option I am just switched on. Okay, so start finish pass close to the entry. So it means that the nearest pocket. Okay, nearest pocket you machine it first, then next is the next nearest. But here I am, so difficult for me to show you that. So these are the parameters. Now the question is, so I need to do the roughing. After that I need to do the finishing. So and this job thickness, just to check it some, as I told you, there is some criticality in this, so I will analyze and check the thickness of this job. I will say distance from that point to this point. Okay, I will make it 3D. So it shows that 0.8 mm. This means the sheet is less than 1 mm, is 0.8 mm. This plate I need to machine, okay, like gasket material, okay, it is. How you can see that how much distance the margin between the pocket and the outer wall, you can see it's very less. It's around 1 mm, it is around 1 mm is there, okay. You can see in the other side also, it is also around nearest. I am just trying to check it. It's around 2 mm. Okay. So now if I start cutting this job directly by 0.5 mm thickness, then there may be chances this shape will get wobble. Or sometimes the material is soft material, maybe there may be chances it may break also on the edges. If you use the normal method, whatever we are doing, that method, if you use it for machining this, then there may be chances the material will break. Okay, so for that there is a thin wall machining. Okay, so in that situation, for machining thin material, so you can use the by depth option. Okay, so whatever the materials will below 1.5 mm, it comes under the thin material. So whenever you are working with the thin material, you should take care of the roughing and finishing. Okay, so so now we are going to see about the thin wall machining. Okay, so what it does, I'll do one thing. I make a 3 passes, 0.2, 0.2, so it means 6 passes. Okay, so I'll say 10 passes. Okay, so it will rough out, it will rough out inside first. So rough step over, I have kept depth is given 0.5. When it finishing comes, so when doing the finishing, it cuts very less depth of material, so it will cut in the 10 passes. So 0.6 mm away from the edge, it will cut out the rough out. The remaining 0.6, it will cut in the very little. Okay, so what will happen now? So now we say machine by depth. Okay, roughing will happen very fast, but by finishing, it will take very fine finishing it will do. So because of that reason, the edge will be safe there, because that load on the edge will be less. Okay, so if you said by depth means, so it will take same depth in all the pockets. Suppose 0.1 in one pocket means next pocket also 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. Then next step it will go to the 0.2, 0.2, 0.2. Like this it will cut. So by doing the cut by thin wall machining, so you can cut the very thin material very nicely by using this method. This is called the thin wall machining. So here the edge condition will be good. There will not be any damage on the edges or wobbling on the shape of the component. So you will get the very good product. So this is the thin wall machining. Here you can change the cutting method by either by conventional method or climb milling. So it is up to you. Okay. So now we can see what is 0.5. So it means that maximum depth is 0.5. Whatever roughing you have given, that it will take as a maximum rough. The finishing depth is less than 10 times smaller than the that is the maximum calculated rough step. By balancing these two, it will make the cutting on the thin material. So when there is a chances of shape change or wobbling of the shape or breaking of the edges, that time you can utilize this toolpath for the so wherever there is a thin material I want to machine, and this is a very good toolpath for the machining. Okay. Then thin wall machining, always you need to use the bi-depth option only. This bi-depth option only meant for the machining the thin material, not for the general machining. In thin wall machining, still more fine machining by you can use this thin wall machining. See, this bi-depth option is always available in the contour also. Where there is a thin profile you need to machine, that situation you can use the thin wall contour machining. But here thin wall pocket machining means that pocket to be cut, in that situation you can use a pocket thin wall machining. So this is very good option. Many people who work in the sheet metal industries, where the where the aircraft shell, outer shell is made, no? Maybe it is all of aluminium material. And that kind of situation, this kind of machining or strategies are necessary. So those who are doing the routing of aircraft shell and that kind of application, this is a very highly used toolpath. Okay, thank you.